you're preparing a new product design and you plan to use plastic injection molding for high volume production, congratulations. You've made the smart choice. After all, PIM is the fastest and the most cost-effective way to make unlimited volumes of identical plastic parts for almost any application. However, before mass production begins, you may be looking at a serious investment in tools and materials. In this episode of Factory Insights, brought to you by Star Rapid, we'll show you how to reduce this investment so you have more resources available to help in other areas of product development. When you choose polyurethane vacuum casting to make high-fidelity, rapid prototypes, you can save money in at least three major ways. And stay to the end for a bonus tip. Number one, no investment in fixed tooling. This is the single largest upfront cost for PIM. Eventually, you'll need to make a hard tool when going to mass production. There's no getting around that. But you don't want to do it until you're sure that the design is dialed in and exactly matches your intent. Polyurethane vacuum casting lets you produce reusable silicon molds that can make up to 20 copies of the master pattern, enough for testing, design optimization, and even crowdfunding campaigns. You can even make multiple tools with slight design modifications, and this will still be much cheaper than a single hard steel or aluminum mold. And if your design calls for overmolding, that also means an additional dedicated tool. This expense can be rationalized by using a silicon vacuum casting overmold first. Number two, no minimum volume of resin. Plastic injection molding requires the use of resin pellets, and resin suppliers demand a minimum order purchase of at least 1 ton of material. That's a substantial cost when you just want to slowly scale up volume over time. One way to mitigate this investment is by using pourable casting resins. Vacuum casting resins mimic the look and feel of conventional thermoforming plastic, but you only purchase the exact quantity you need for your parts. No waste. This is a great way to ensure you've got the look, feel, and performance you want before you commit to a larger order. Number three, no masterbatch pigment. Masterbatch pigment is used to colorize large volumes of resin during injection molding. For custom colored parts, this also means buying a minimum quantity of masterbatch, usually enough to make up to 50 tons of finished plastic parts. With polyurethane vacuum casting, pigment can be added directly to the resin as it's poured. Again, you only use exactly what you need when you need it. Finally, did we mention that polyurethane vacuum casting is also fast? Finished parts can be made in as little as 1 week, and that's the bonus tip. After all, time is money. Reducing the product development lead time brings you closer to where you want to be, making finished parts for your market. You can also prepare silicon molds at the same time that your PIM tools are being built, so after you've tested your prototypes, you can go right into production. Another savings in valuable time. When you put these four factors together, you can begin to see how smart it is to take a closer look at polyurethane vacuum casting when you're preparing rapid prototypes for new plastic injection molding designs. We hope these insights have been helpful to you. Remember to like us, ding the bell, consider subscribing, and we'll be back next time with more factory insights from your friends at Star Rapid.